see who won. Oh. Cyberpunk Edgerunners is a revolutionary sci-fi masterclass that improves upon the terrible game that Cyberpunk 2077 was. Is what I would say if I was some mainstream bandwagoner. I usually don't make review videos like this, but something has been bothering me for the past few months, so maybe this will be a way to soothe that, even if no one watches it. So, I'll set the scene for you. It's December 18th, 2022. I just got done with my week of mourning, don't ask, and picked up the remote to watch something. As I went to Netflix, I saw a new show based off my favorite game, Cyberpunk Edgerunners. Excitement couldn't explain how I felt. I had heard that they were producing it, but I only expected a 30-minute special or a short movie. But instead, it was a whole anime. So I watched, and I watched. When I was done, I thought it was quite average. As I went to my anime list, rated 6, I saw something unexpected. Not only was it rated higher than I had expected, it was the 80th highest rated anime on my anime list. Let me explain why this game is such a shock to me. Though, I actually wrote a whole explanation of Cyberpunk Edgerunners, but I don't really think you guys need that, because if you're watching this video, I'm sure you already know what Cyberpunk Edgerunners is. So, I'll just summarize it by saying it's a generic tropey show about a kid in a totalitarian government. So what makes it so bad? Well, my number one reason is that this show ran out of time, or at least they had really bad pacing. Edgerunners had long episodes, it's even 60 minutes longer than the usual anime, but at the end of episode 10, I didn't really feel anything. And one of the reasons for that is the show crammed what should have been 2 seasons, in my opinion, into 1 extra long one with short episodes. I felt as though the directors had forced production to do this, which is why it feels so odd. With at least 3 or 4 more episodes, the moments that were meant to make the audience feel emotion would have hit 5 times harder, in my opinion. There's even a character that dies so early on, some people don't even consider it a spoiler. Lucy's backstory is also only mentioned once or twice after the initial explanation. And I decided I'll switch this up, actually. So here's one reason I like Edgerunners. The animation is some of the best I saw in 2022. Like, I mean beautiful. There are 2 ways to judge if an anime has good animation. They're with guns, they're with cars. Do the guns shine like they're made of real metal? Does the car have perfect shadows in every corner? If so, just like in Edgerunners, you can tell the animators paid a lot of attention to every little detail. The second reason I don't like Edgerunners, it had the opportunity to be like the game, which had an amazing plot, but it ripped that up. So don't get me wrong, I didn't want just an anime version of the game, despite how good that would be, but the fact that Johnny Silverhand isn't mentioned at all disturbs me. The game had an amazing interpretation of Night City, which is what I believe Edgerunners should've and could've done. Number 3 reason, spoiler alert by the way, if you haven't finished Edgerunners, the betrayal of Kiwi seems like a shoehorn plot twist and the explanation for Faraday finding Lucy. In normal gang, sure, I can believe it, but not in the Edgerunners group. Since day one, it's been established that everyone there is a close-knit community, and have been for years, so why did Kiwi betray them just to get out? She should know that there is no out for a merc, and she finds this shortly after selling them out. From my viewpoint, it makes no sense. For a reason, spoilers again. The sudden, abrupt ending essentially closes off all paths for a continuation. Now, I do know there is going to be a season 2, but it won't feel like Edgerunners. After essentially, huge spoilers here, the entire crew died, it's just gonna feel like a spin-off. And when that season 2 does come, season 1 will probably be looked down upon for the ending. I would have preferred if it was just like a movie or something, that would have been 3 times better. What I did like about the ending, though, is that they didn't totally write off Adam Smasher's strength. Just like in the actual original lore, Adam Smasher cannot be beaten by just any person, and that includes David. And just a little side thing here, I didn't know where else to put this. I didn't like nor dislike the romance between David and Lucy. Actually, I think it just dissipated from my memory as soon as I finished the series. I love romance, and especially when it's a subplot, but this just didn't do it for me for some reason. I love the romance in Ultimate Blade Works, Kimisen, Uma, and many others, but this just felt half-hearted for some reason. I get the Moon Brain Dance was meant to be intimate and all, but I didn't really feel it. Number 4 reason I don't like Edgerunners, and this is gonna get me a lot of hate. Rebecca. I don't know what it is that engages such a primal rage in me, but Rebecca just makes me so mad. First off, she has that character design. Second off, her name is Rebecca. And third, she has the worst personality in Shonen. Small, angry, childish character that is always screaming. Every time she got angry, started shouting, I lost a piece of my soul. When her brother died, she got over it like that. I know people love her, but I really couldn't get along with her character. So, in the end, the anime isn't bad. In fact, it's great, at times. It is insanely patchy, which is simply the main reason why I cannot call it better than I think it is. Okay, would I suggest it to someone? I guess so. Would I rather watch it or play through Cyberpunk 2077 again? I'd probably rather the latter. Maybe I set my expectations too high with the game, but I was just disappointed by Edgerunners as a whole. Although if you want to find a reason for me to dislike it, maybe it's because it was animated by Trigger, possibly one of my least favorite studios. Since 2017, people have been talking about Studio Trigger's terrible pacing. This is why I believe the pacing in Edgerunners isn't a stylistic choice, and anyone who says otherwise simply has never watched a Trigger anime besides Edgerunners. The only other anime you need to watch by Trigger to prove my point is BNA. Just like Edgerunners, they crammed all of their ideas into one season, which led to bad pacing. The only difference between BNA and Cyberpunk Edgerunners is that Edgerunners received so much hype, people ignored the terrible pacing. That's why it scores 1.3% higher than BNA. Is Edgerunners good? Yes. Could it be better? Absolutely. Do I want it to be better? 100%. Thank you for watching my video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.